Today, I'm going to take a look at network pinning in Proxmox. This is a new feature that's been brought into Proxmox version 9 and allows you to pin network devices. So adding something like an NVMe device doesn't bring a system offline. I've had this comment bite me a few times, made me manually edit config files on the server room at 2 a.m. And I'm really happy that they have a relatively easy fix. I'm going to take a look at it in this video, dive into why this is an issue in the first place and what's going on a bit under the hood, and try it on an actual Proxmox system to see what's happening on a real box. So, if you've been a Linux user for a little bit or used Proxmox and dove into the network settings, you might recognize names like ENP2S0 or ENS10F0 or other names. And this is how Linux uses to identify its network cards. And Proxmox, being built upon Debian Linux, also uses all these names to identify the cards. The reason why they have all these weird, strange names is they're part of the predictable network names that systemd brought up a while ago, which compared to the old solution, which just had the ETH0 or ETH1 names, that could just change depending on how the system was booting and deciding to do it. And these names are decided based off things like the PCIe bus number, amongst other characteristics. So, for example, on one system, an ENP2S0 could be PCIe bus 2 with device 0, or the first device on that network card on PCIe. Now, that worked pretty well and meant that the network card on that device was the same name across multiple reboots or other system changes. The issue comes along that I've experienced with these NVMe devices. I find it moderately frequent that I'm changing storage in system, and now that more and more storage is NVMe devices or even hot swap front bays, so it feels like any other drive, that means I could add a PCIe device, and depending on how your system is laid out, that could make it so that your network card is now on a different bus, because they're frequently just ordered sequentially in the system depending on how many devices are being used. And if you're guessing that, now this network card has a new device and your network config files aren't configged and linked correctly, yep, that's right, the network stops working. So let's actually take a look at that now. So I have a mini PC set up here with Proxmox installed on an external drive. I've turned it on to boot right now, and it should just have network access, and I can see that my single onboard network card on the system is named ENP1S0. And likely where that name is coming from is it's that PCIe bus number 1 if I run LSPCI. And then it's a single adapter network card, so it's that 0 means the first port on the network adapter. Now, this all works fine and dandy, and I have network access on the system, and I've never had issues where it would assign it to a different device on something like this. The issue comes from if I go shut this system down and start inserting these SSDs, it'll change those bus numbers and change the names. And now my mini PC has two network devices plugged in, and if I try to SSH into it again, it's not online, and my little network adapter lights also aren't turned on, so I can see something is odd. So I'm gonna go type my password into this system, and if I run LSPCI, it's probably gonna be hard to see on camera, but I can see that this Ethernet controller, instead of being bus 1 like it was previously, is now on bus 2. And what that also means is if I run IPA, my network adapter, instead of being named ENP1S0, is now named ENP2S0. And if you are paying extra close attention, you might have noticed that I added two NVMe SSDs or PCIe devices, but it still only got nudged up one. And that's something I've noticed on a lot of systems. Depending on how the actual board is designed and laid out, and probably the firmware a little bit too, determines how all these buses get ordered, which determines if the name changes at all. Some systems I've had, you can add or remove as many NVMe devices as you want, and it doesn't affect the onboard networking. But some like this will be affected by that. So the first step I'm gonna do is just remove these SSDs again and get it back into a known working state that I can SSH into. Let's take a look at the fix that Proxmox created in Proxmox Virtualization version 9. And this tool is called PVE-network-interface-pinning. There doesn't appear to be any GUI version or web GUI version that you can use right now, but again, it is available in the command line to insert it. And in the full Proxmox documents, they have information on how to use it. So by default, you can just type the command here and then generate, and it will run all of this by default, and then they explain the other options if you want specific prefixes, only want to use specific network names, give it target names, and more. And the TLDR of what this is doing under the hood is it's using systemd's link files. And that will basically assign a network interface a specific name, which Proxmox by default would generate, or you can determine yourself as an admin on the system based on other characteristics of the network card. And it actually explains a little bit more of what it's doing under the hood here, but let's just run this command and see what it says when I run it first, and then try to dive into what it's actually doing under the hood. So I'm going to run the most basic command on my system right now, so just PVE network interface pinning generate. And that should generate a pinned interface for all of my network addresses. It's going to prompt me, do I actually want to do that? And it says, hey, it came up with a new name for the system, and it's going to change it to just NIC0. It made link files, it stored those link files there, it's updated some other config files as it's mentioned there, and it says reboot to apply those settings. So let's actually dive into a little bit of what it's doing. So the first thing is it's made a new link name, or kind of under the hood name for this network card. So it's ENX and then this 38F7. This number here seems to be the MAC address, and from everything I can tell, what it's using is it's using the MAC address of the network card to link it, instead of the default way in Linux using predictable network names using things like the bus ID and more. And I'm sure there's reasons they didn't use the MAC, which I think theoretically should be unique on all network cards, but it seems to make a lot of sense because the MAC address should be the same on your network card no matter where you plug it in. And if we take a closer look at where it put those link files, we can see in this user local lib systemd network, we can see they have a match of a MAC address and it has to be an Ethernet adapter. And now it will just name it NIC0 instead of its previous name. And this way you can tell systemd to manually name your network cards however you like. And there's a full man page on systemd if you want to see exactly how you can make custom files and do anything you want. The other files it's edited are the etc system network interface and these other PVE files. And all of these files depend on the network card name to do their configuration. So for example, I can see in my system, this is my old interfaces file that used that ENP1S0, and it's also made a .new file that it will apply on boot, and it's changed it to NIC0. Because if these files aren't updated, they're going to refer to a network card named ENP1S0 that no longer exists or is an old card. So let's try doing what it says to do, which is to just reboot the system. I do also want to make one quick note. While this shouldn't affect the data on your system and should just be a quick reboot and come back online, I always like to prepare for the worst case scenario in doing any sort of host maintenance. And if I SSH into the same IP, I can just get back online from my system right now. It just works without any issue. If I run IPA, I can see it's named NIC0 on my system right now. It works just the same, it just has a different name. And if I go into the web interface for my Proxmox system and go on the network, I can just see the name is NIC0. It has an alternate name based off the MAC address of this card, this ENX name. And otherwise, it's identical in terms of configuration, has all the same VLANs, and just works fine. I also want to test the one thing that it should fix, which is adding these NVMe devices. So I'm just going to plug these devices in once it shuts down and see, does the name change again? And now it's time for the real test. Does the network address actually change after adding my NVMe devices? I'm going to try to SSH into the system right now. And it's online again with the same IP. And if I run IPA, I can see my NIC0 name hasn't changed. Overall, this is a really nice little tool that Proxmox adds, and I'm really happy that over the last few releases, Proxmox has been working on putting a lot of these smaller tools that really make little things easier. Yeah, the actual configuration files in systemd have been there for a long time, and I could write those files, but having essentially one command to do that and keeping me from having to research it saves me a lot of time, and that's what I look for in something like Proxmox, where you're taking a lot of good open source code and putting it together for a virtualization use case and trying to make it easy on a sysadmin like me to minimize the amount of steps or man pages I have to read trying to make a system work. Now, the one thing I would like to see them add is build upon this, which is give me an option in the GUI to do the same thing. So it's less things I have to dive into command line for. And maybe even have one on the initial install of like pin devices automatically for all the existing NICs that it saws when you install your system. There might be some edge cases where it might not make sense, but I think this is a decent default on all the systems I've tried, and I'm gonna be doing this as part of my main setup procedure on all my systems because I use NVMe devices so much and change them relatively frequently and hate that 2 a.m. why is my system not online? I have to walk out and manually change stuff because it's not on the network anymore. Let me know your thoughts on the PVE network pinning that's brought in version 9, if you've used it, and what your experiences have been with it. Thanks for watching this little Proxmox video, and I'm looking forward to reading your comments below.